Hello, I'm Timothy Jordan for The Developer Show, and this is your weekly update on the coolest developer news from Google. Now, Google I.O. was last week, which means there's way too much to share in this short video. But here's the highlights, and as always, you can get more details and sample code and videos and all sorts of stuff by clicking in the description below on YouTube or sliding up on Instagram. Let's start with what's new in Android. Head on over to this post to learn all about the Android announcements, including the first beta of Android 12, which just started rolling out, Jetpack Compose going to 1.0 in July, Android Studio Arctic Fox now in beta, and there have been several big steps for Wear. Firebase had a host of new announcements as well. Firebase App Distribution now supports Android app bundles for streamlined testing. AppCheck is an additional layer of security that protects access to your services by verifying that incoming traffic is coming from your app and blocking traffic that doesn't have valid credentials. It's now available in beta. New extensions that help you implement search on Firestore with Algolia, send personalized emails to your customers with MailChimp, communicate with your users with MessageBird, and analyze user-generated content with the Perspective API from Jigsaw. And finally, real-time data for performance monitoring and a revamped dashboard. Google Pay introduced a Flutter plugin for payments, giving you the ability to add functionality to your apps across platforms with a single and familiar code base written in Dart. We developed the Developer Library as a space where we can highlight the best open source projects related to Google technologies. Google Assistant made adding Assistant to your Android app easier with App Actions. Introduced a new framework API in beta called Capabilities that lets you declare support for common tasks defined by built-in intents, and improved user discoverability with app shortcuts in Android 12. AR Core introduced a new AR Core raw depth API, providing more detailed representations of the geometry of objects in the scene by generating raw depth maps with corresponding confidence images, as well as a new AR Core recording and playback API, enabling you to record not just video footage, but also IMU and depth sensor data. We announced Flutter 2.2 with updates that make it easier than ever for you to monetize your apps through in-app purchases, payments, and ads, to connect to cloud services and APIs that extend apps to support new capabilities, and with tooling and language features that allow you to eliminate a whole class of errors, increase app performance, and reduce package size. Two new WebGL-powered features for the Maps JavaScript API in beta are Tilt and Rotation, and WebGL Overlay View. Cloud-based map styling, a set of capabilities to help you customize, manage, and deploy your maps from the Google Cloud Console, is generally available for the Maps JavaScript API and the Maps Static API. We announced the general availability of Vertex AI, a managed machine learning platform that allows you to accelerate the deployment and maintenance of artificial intelligence models. Now, Vertex AI requires nearly 80% fewer lines of code to train a model versus competitive platforms. Angular DevTools is a Chrome DevTools extension that you can use to inspect the structure of your applications and profile their performance. This release focuses on visualization of the component structure and understanding the change detection execution. TensorFlow announced that the TensorFlow Lite runtime is going to be bundled with Google Play services, meaning you don't need to distribute it with your app. TensorFlow Lite includes built-in support for SysTrace, integrating seamlessly with Perfetto for Android 10, and you can now run TensorFlow Lite models on the web. TFX is now 1.0 and ready today for production ML at enterprise scale, including enterprise-grade support, security patches, bug fixes, and guaranteed backward compatibility for the entire 1.x release cycle. Starting with TensorFlow 2.5, you can easily train powerful decision forest models, including random forests and gradient-boosted trees, using familiar Keras APIs. Remember, you can get more details and sample code by clicking in the description below on YouTube or sliding up on Instagram. Also, please like, subscribe, and share. I'm Timothy Jordan for the Developer Show. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week. Hello, my name is Timothy Jordan, and I'm talking to a phone. That's my dog, Astro.